and welcome. Today, the Living with Wildlife Illinois team is talking about black bears in Illinois. I'm Laura Kamen.
And I'm Kathy Andrews Wright. Today, we're joined by Illinois Department of Natural Resources wildlife biologist Stefanie Fitzsimons. Stefanie, can you give us a little bit of a description about what your role is with the IDNR?
Sure. Yeah, my official title is District Wildlife Biologist. My district includes Lake County, McHenry County, and Kane County. But since April 1st, I am also dubbed the temporarily assigned wildlife disease and large carnivore biologist for the state.
Thanks, Stefanie. So some of our viewers may have watched this past June the story of the black bear who made a southward trek through Illinois. But before we get to that story, I was wondering, Stefanie, if you could give our viewers a little bit of sort of historical background about black bear populations in Illinois and maybe talk about any of the recent sightings that have happened over the past few years.
Sure. Black bears there is a historic range of black bear in Illinois. We don't have any breeding populations right now. They were eliminated in the 1800s. But in the recent couple decades, we've had a number of black bears actually wander into Illinois. The most recent one was just this year, but back in 2018, we had a black bear come into Bureau County and hang out for a while. That one, we're still considering that one perhaps a captive bear that may have gotten loose just based on its condition and its size and its actions. But that one was captured and taken into human custody. The next one was in 2009, and that one actually started on the Iowa side of the Mississippi River. Near Carroll County and Joe Davies County, and it wandered into Illinois near Savannah and hung out for a while and then wandered up into Wisconsin. So we're thinking that its origin was probably from Wisconsin, which that state has a pretty healthy bear population. 2014, kind of a similar case happened where a bear wandered from Wisconsin into kind of the Joe Davies area. This one stayed around for a while and actually wandered as far down as Rochelle and over to Rockford and then wandered back up into Wisconsin. And then 2019, there was a bear in Johnson County. They did not actually see this bear, but they had DNA analysis on scat and things because it was tampering with the beehive. So they never actually saw that one. But the DNA evidence was there that it had paid a visit to Illinois. And then this year we had the bear that wandered in from Wisconsin and made a voyage to Missouri. And it was here for about a month.
Thank you for that background. Now we know that the bear that was here in June was a younger bear and a male bear. And those are the ones that typically go about this big walkabout. If you'll have it. So can you please tell us more about the story of this bear and its epic journey through the state of Illinois?
Sure, yeah. IDNR works with USDA Wildlife Services. And on June 5th, I received an email from Dakota Bird, who is their large carnivore specialist, that he had received an email from Wisconsin that there was a black bear hanging around Monroe, Wisconsin, which is north of Freeport, Illinois. And, you know, in the past, obviously, you know, if they reach the that close to the state line, usually we prepare for a visit. Well, that bear didn't actually show up in Illinois until June 10th. And had actually wandered over into the Joe Davies County area near Galena. And actually, one of the first sightings was near East Dubuque. And that was, like I said, June 10th. And it hung around East Dubuque for a while, but then actually swam the Mississippi River and decided to wander Iowa a little bit. So we worked with the Iowa DNR and their state fur bear biologist, which also does large carnivore stuff, and kind of monitored where he was wandering around over there, because we figured it's very possible that he was going to come back into Illinois, which he did. And he came back on June 18th. He swam the Mississippi River again, and he came in through Andalusia. There's an island there called Andalusia Island, and then he came into the actual town of Andalusia and started venturing south. One of the first big crowd gatherings that conservation police had to deal with was on Father's Day weekend. He walked right through the town of Oquaka, and a couple hundred people decided they needed to take a picture with the black bear. So after that, the bear was like a rock star, and it pretty much had CPOs helping it every night cross the streets. And it was a whirlwind of activity. There were the CPOs and myself had many evenings where we were scrolling on Facebook because the bear had a large social media following. We were texting each other, we were emailing each other. People down in Springfield were getting updates from me at like 11 o'clock at night. It was wild because everybody wanted to be a part of this bear's journey. So we had to give the bear some protection. So the conservation police were awesome with that. It actually finally ended up hitting the Mississippi River again near Clarksville, Missouri. On June 30th, he jumped into the Mississippi River again. And I have to give a shout out to Tim Crumwitty, my coworker down in that county. He's a district wildlife biologist, and he was just amazing, giving me updates and helping with crowd control. And he actually was on a boat in the Mississippi River as the bear was swimming across, just in case things went a little south. And on June 30th, he got onto Clarksville Island in the river, spent the night there, and then on July 1st, he was seen in Ellsbury, Missouri. So we knew that he was now in Missouri and actually walking towards bear country. So.
All right, and one thing, the black bear is one of the protected species in Illinois, is that correct?
Correct. So, yeah. In 2015, we passed the Large Carnivore Act, which gives protection to our three major large carnivores that we tend to see on rare occasions here. So black bears are protected, gray wolves are protected, and cougars are protected, which means that people cannot hunt them or harass them for no reason. For at least cougars and black bears, if you plan on shooting them, you need to have a very good reason. For gray wolves, they're federally protected. They're a federally endangered species. So that's definitely hands off. If you see one, leave it alone and let us know.
Following up on that, I assume that future black bear sightings are still going to be rare in Illinois for the foreseeable future. But because their populations are still growing in places like Missouri and Wisconsin and elsewhere, it seems likely that we'll maybe get another black bear rock star coming through the state at some point. So what advice do you have for people? What should people do if they see a black bear, or if they find signs that they think might be black bear, what do they do?
Sure. Well, because Wisconsin has a very thriving population, we have no doubt that in the near future and in the future, we will be seeing more black bears making these journeys down into Illinois. So what we ask the public to do is let us know right away so that we can let the conservation officers know, let the biologists know, or let the conservation officers know so that we can work together to offer protection to the animal and also offer protection to humans. We try to educate people with the Be Bear Aware campaign. everybody's really excited to see these animals because, you know, we don't see them very often in Illinois. So everybody wants to take that selfie or take that picture or see that animal. Black bears are a pretty timid species, so they aren't going to attack unless they're provoked. So, you know, we tell people, please leave them alone, stay at least 100 yards back. If you need to take a picture, take your picture and go. And if the bear ends up getting into trash cans or beehives or things like that, let us know so that we can work with USDA Wildlife Services to rectify the problem. But definitely if you see one, please let us know, and you can do that. You can report a sighting on the Wildlife Illinois website, but you can also contact your local conservation officer as well so that they can work with us.
Okay, that's great, Stefanie. Thanks. Thanks for answering all of our questions. Is there anything else with regards to the black bear that you would like some our listeners to know about?
Sure. One of the main issues with this black bear this year was the overcrowding and everybody wanting to take a picture. And a lot of times we needed to remind the public that, you know, this bear's existence here in Illinois is 100% dependent on how people are acting. And people didn't always act appropriately around the bear. And we didn't want to have to interfere with its journey by, you know, having to relocate it or anything. We just wanted it to do its bear thing. So next time this happens, we just want to make sure people understand that if we don't want to see the animal harmed, you don't want to see the animal harmed, then everybody needs to act appropriately and follow the Be Bear Aware campaign, stay 100 yards back, and give it its space so that it can end up wherever it wants to end up, find a mate, you know, have some babies, and everybody's happy then.
That sounds great. Thanks, Stefanie. Mm-hmm. So that wraps up today's Q&A on black bears. Our next Q&A is going to be on other large carnivores, rare visitors to Illinois, gray wolves, and cougars. Until then, keep those questions coming into Wildlife Illinois, and we'll see you next time. Mm-hmm.